Wicked Yak Fishing here with another video. Remember, hit that subscribe and share. Get Wicked Yak Fishing out there. So today, what I have is, some people are already aware that I had a leftover trailer that I was customizing for my Old Town 120 PDL. So I thought today would go over that trailer. Really minimal customization that I did to it, just so that I can haul it easily from water to water. As you can see, it's right here, because I have my Old Town in the water right now. Stay with me, we'll go take a look at it. All right, so here we go. Here's the trailer. This is a trailer that I used to have a 16-foot aluminum John boat on, but I thought I'd get more use out of it for my kayak. Like I said, I didn't want to do anything crazy or anything like that. I just wanted really basic so I could get it lifted, get it going, and get it out of here. So some scrap wood, I think that's 3-inch PVC. Guess what? The boat fits like a dream. It's very sturdy, as you can see. It's not going anywhere. I screwed it right in to the frame. And then also, I went to Lowe's. I picked up these ratchets here. These things are amazing. Work great with the boat. These are great. I have one back here just connected to the frame for now. And I have one here also, just looped around the frame. It holds the boat perfectly. And then the bow sits up here. And literally, I just have a rope that I run through this old basic ratchet right here. And it locks it down from the front and gives me that security when I'm launching it. As you can see, the PVC is not straight because I had to fit it to the bottom of my boat. So I had to angle it narrower in the back and wider up the front to allow clearance, especially for my sonar sensor. That was a big problem here, is that, you know, loading in and out of my truck, I didn't want to scratch up and damage the brand new fish finder where it is mounted under the kayak. But this has been a dream. It's made launching so much simpler. Like I said, it's really basic. You know, I may go through, maybe paint it, I don't know. I'm not big into that. I really don't care. It's about doing the job. And I'll tell you what, this does the job. My kayak doesn't go anywhere when it's loaded. Now here's the boat. Like I said, I currently have it in the water because I was just fishing. So it's chilling here. I do want to let everybody know that I will have, for right here, this part right here, I do have a 30-pound thrust Minn Kota coming in shortly, that I will be mounting back here with the adjustable seat and an extension handle. I should be able to control it pretty good. And I'll still use the rudder for steering left and right, because the pedals are great, but not to get to the other side of this lake. And I found that out yesterday. So up in the front storage hatch, I have a battery for my fish finder now. I'm gonna mount also the battery for the trolling motor up there to counterbalance the weight that's gonna be back here. And like I said, I don't even need the tiller handle because I'm just gonna use it. I just need to be able to crank it on, and then my rudder is gonna control my direction left and right, right here with the handle. It's gonna be amazing. Fish with my seat further up, but in order to use the trolling motor, I back the seat up so I can reach it a little easier, and then I can readjust my seat when I get to where I'm going, and then use my pedals as I'm out on the water. So I'm really stoked about giving this a go.